Hey everybody, it's Jake Tapper from CNN's State of the Union and factcheck.org, and today we're going to take a look at two statements, one from the Democratic side and one from the Republican side, about this latest development in the FBI's investigation into Hillary Clinton's email server, the private server that she used. Let's start with a statement from Hillary Clinton, former Secretary of State, about the letter that FBI Director Comey sent to members of Congress. Take a listen.
We've made it very clear that if they're going to be sending this kind of letter that is only going originally to Republican members of the House, that they need to share whatever facts they claim to have with the American people.
Is that true? Did FBI Director Comey's letter originally only go to Republican members of Congress? No, that is not true. The letter was addressed to the Republican chairman of 8 House and Senate committees, given that Republicans control the House and Senate. But take a look at the letter. At the bottom there, you will see the names of the ranking Democratic members of those same committees, showing that it went to Democrats as well. And in fact, one of them, Congressman Elijah Cummings, the ranking Democrat on the House Oversight Committee, issued a statement that same day indicating that he had indeed received the letter. So Secretary Clinton's claim is false. And we should point out that the Clinton campaign said that Secretary Clinton misspoke when speaking to a different fact checker, our friends at PolitiFact. Now to the second statement. It comes from Indiana governor and vice presidential nominee for the Republicans, Mike Pence. Take a listen.
Hillary Clinton continues to refuse to turn over some 33,000 emails.
Is that true? Does Hillary Clinton continue to refuse to turn over 33,000 emails? No. That is not true. What Governor Pence is referring to is 33,000 emails, 31,000 really, that Secretary Clinton and her team deleted. They're not there anymore. She can't turn them over. They no longer exist. Let's step back. On December 5th, 2014, Hillary Clinton gave the State Department 30,000 work-related emails, and she, quote, chose not to keep 31,830 emails that she deemed personal and not related to State Department business. Now, we've learned during the course of the FBI investigation that those emails, the 31,830, were deleted sometime during the final week of March 2015. Now, the emails were not deleted by Clinton, but rather by an employee of Platte River Networks, the firm hired by Clinton to manage her private email server. Now, let me point out that many argue that Platte River Networks should not have deleted those emails, given that they were all of the emails were under congressional subpoena. And there are still others that question whether Secretary Clinton was really the best person to judge whether or not an email was personal or professional in nature. And those are perfectly legitimate arguments to make. But what Governor Pence claimed, that Hillary Clinton had 33,000 emails and she was refusing to turn them over, that is not true. She no longer has those emails. A reminder to all the politicians out there, you're perfectly entitled to your own opinions, not to your own facts. I'm Jake Tapper for CNN State of the Union and factcheck.org.